There is no way to create a great image without understanding the lighting. Today, we'll fix this once and for all. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will discuss the characteristics of the lights. Without this knowledge, you won't be able to create a decent lighting for your visualizations. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you won't miss any future tutorials. Intensity refers to the strength of the light. It's the most basic and easy to understand characteristic. In 3ds Max, intensity of the light can be set here. Lower values mean that the light is less bright, while higher values will give you more intense, brighter light. The intensity of the light affects the images in many ways. For example, we associate bright lights with a cheerful and dramatic atmosphere, while dark lights is more mysterious and melancholic. The position of the light relative to the object makes a huge difference. Obviously, if we position the light closer to the object, the image gets brighter, but also sharper. And the opposite, if we move the light further from the object, the lighting is darker and more soft. It's not all random. You can actually calculate it using the inverse square law. According to the law, the power of the light is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So if we take a distance of 2 and square it, we'll get 4th, and inverse of which will be 1/4. So in this case, the light will be 1/4 of the original power, not half. For 1 meter, the strength is 100%, because 1 square is still 1. Moving the object 3 meters from the light, 3 square is equal 9, so we have 1/9. So in this case, our light source becomes now 1/9 of what it originally was. For 4 meters, it will be 1/16. For 5 meters, it will be 1/25. And for 6, it will be 1/36, and so on. To make it more clear, let me show you how it works in 3ds Max. I have created this scale showing the distance from the object. Now I have the light 1 meter from the object. I will duplicate the render window so we can compare it later. Now I will move the light 2 meters from the object. We know that in this case, light intensity has to be 2 square, so 4 times more intense. You can see it's very similar. Let's do the same for a 3 meter distance. 3 square equals 9, so the light has to be 9 times more intense to have the same effect. And finally, I will place 4 meters from the object. 4 square equals 16. And here we go. All the images are very similar. Only difference is the softness. The distance between the light and the object affects the softness of the light source. So further away from the object, the softer the light is. We can position the light in different angles relative to the subject. The direction of the light can shape the object and space in different ways. If the light hits the object at the same angle, for example 45 degrees, the shadows are visible and we can notice the image depth. Object depth is also visible. We have very bright and very dark areas. If we position the light straight from the front, the subject looks relatively flat. This lighting makes the object lack details as there are no shadows and depth created. When we lit the object from behind, the object appears dark, and we can see only its silhouette. Same light, totally different effect. Light can be soft or hard, and we can control it by the size of the light. The larger the light source relative to the subject, the softer the output. Softer light creates a nice smooth transition between dark and light. In photography, it typically is created with the use of the diffuser. However, in 3D software, there is no need to do this as we can change the light's parameter, making it bigger and less intense. Hard light instead is harsh, directional, and casts strong shadows and bright highlights. In nature, direct sunlight gives sharp shadows, although it is a huge source of light. It happens because of the enormous distance of the sun from the earth, so the sun becomes relatively small. However, on an overcast day, the sunlight is diffused by the clouds, and the sky becomes a huge, soft light source. Most lights don't emit purely white color and have a specific color temperature expressed in kelvins. In 3ds Max, we can set the light's temperature here. The lower the value, the more warm the light is. And the opposite, higher values will make the light cooler. Color temperature has a tremendous impact on the image and the place it presents. We can control the atmosphere by changing light temperature. We can, for example, make it cozier, more dramatic, add life to the place, or introduce mystery. The real art is to combine these various of color temperatures to create phenomenal scenery in your image. Things get more complicated when you have more than one light in the scene. You cannot just place them randomly with the random values. This is the most common mistake. The challenge is to have the balance between them. To create harmony, we cannot use the same intensities of the light, like in the first example. We have to decide which light is our primary light and make it more intense. Then, use less strong fill lights just to lighten up the shadows from the main light source. Let me show you how to do it. I will turn this light off for now. This will be our key light, which is the main light. It's the strongest light. This light will also cast shadows. Once it's set, I will turn it off. Now this is the fill light. It's not as strong as the key light. We can also make it larger and move it away from the object to make it softer. Its purpose is to lighten up the shadows. It cannot cast its own shadows when both lights are on. Now let's turn on both lights and adjust the values. You can see that fill light is only making shadows lighter. It's not creating new shadows. Additionally, we can add color balance. We can make the key light warmer and the fill light cooler to create a more interesting effect. The main light is giving a warm, orange light, while shadows are cold and blue. Light not only illuminates the things in the scene, it is also bounced off the different surfaces. I've put the wall close to the object. Notice how the color of the wall influences the light on the object. If we make the color darker, this light is bouncing and the shadows are really dark. If we want it white, it's almost as light as a light. The color of the object also affects the bounces of the light, and it influences its color. I will change colors. Notice what's going on with the shadows. If you want to learn this technique, I put the link to the tutorial in the corner. I'm sure it will improve your images a lot. Now, if you found this tutorial useful, I'd like to invite you to check out our visualization training and the book The Art of Artist Images that will drastically help you improve your skills. Both available in our store. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!